John here from Creative 3D. This tutorial will touch on the Lattice tool with Sub D to create the perfume bottle. To download the file and take advantage of the second video, which should be out in the next few days on setup, lighting and texturing, then join my Patreon page link below. Or just to support my work, thanks. Okay, first thing is to delete the cube and then to bring in a cylinder from the pull down or to enter Shift A on the keyboard. Once showing the dialog, then select mesh and then select cylinder. Next, select the pull down on the left and enter 64 vertices and the rest leave as is. Now select the cylinder and then go to edit mode on the left upper area. Once in edit mode, now select the very top face of the cylinder and next select the inset tool on the left side tools. Now inset similar to what I am showing you. Next select the extrude tool as shown or select E on the keyboard and then bring this down into the cylinder. Next enter the S for scale to bring this inward. Next going to again extrude into the cylinder with the E key as shown. Now we need to select the edges by selecting the Alt key and selecting the edges as shown. Once the two loops are selected, which should be highlighted, then hit the Ctrl B to bevel the inner edges as shown. I would go with around 4 to 8 sections on the bevel. Next, select the middle edge line with Alt key to select the loop, and then again hit the Ctrl B to add in a bevel same as before. Now we need to select the interface, so select the faces from the upper left side or select the 3 on the keyboard for face selection, and let's delete this face. Now we need to select the edge tool above or select 2 on keyboard. Once the edge loop is selected with the Alt key, then select the Ctrl F to pull up another window, which now let's select the grid fill tool. I mostly just go with the settings with the span and use the offset to rotate this so it is aligned with the top or sides. Now let's select the edge on the top and lower section with Alt key and the Shift Alt to select the second one, and let's go with around 6. Select the loop cut tool by selecting from the side panel or put in Ctrl R. Once you select the center of the cylinder, then let's add in 15 cuts to help add the ability to deform this correctly. Let's now go to object mode to get out of the edit mode. Next, we need to select the F3 key to do a quick search for the lattice tool. Now that the lattice has been added to the outliner, you can now select this add, increase the number and the resolution to 15 as shown on the right side of the screen. To get to the lattice section, look at the properties tab. Make sure to add in 15 to the resolution section in the W section. Now let's scale up the lattice section so that you can see the cage on the outside of the cylinder. To do this, select the lattice and hit S to scale up. Now let's add a secondary lattice and again select F3 to search for lattice, and this will be set up for the tapering of this object. Next, go to the modifiers tab and we will need to add in the lattice modifier. Once it is now in the section, this needs to be linked to the main cylinder object. So go and select this with the eyedropper so that it can affect the model. But before selecting with the eyedropper, let's scale up the modifier to be able to see this outside of the cylinder. Now that the lattice cage has been scaled up, we can start to add in additional sections to the lattice cage. Okay, cool, now that the box is higher and wider, let's add in more details. Now let's use the link tool and select the cylinder so that now both lattice controllers will affect the cylinder. Okay, now let's select the taper cage. I suggest that you name this to make it easier to know which one you are selecting. Once selected, you can then go to the lattice section on the properties tab, and there we can add in more details. So let's go with 4 sections on the resolution on the W so that we can manipulate what we need. Now that the lattice is selected, now go to the edit mode and select the 4 top points. Deselect any points that might have been selected by accident. Now let's hit the S key to scale in the top points as shown on the video. Next, select the next 4 points on the second line and also scale them in as shown on the video. The objective here is to taper this unit to the look the way you want it, and then the second lattice will be used for the rotation warp. Now let's select the 3 section with the 4 points and again scale in as shown. Looking good, however, we still need to go back to the top and let's again scale this down. This is starting to take a nice form. Now let's keep working the scaling taper to get to the shape that was created for this video. Still need to drive the skinnier, however, part of the video was not recorded to the last position of the tapered object. Okay, now let's select the cylinder object, and the next step is to select each of the rows going vertical for every other one so that we can push in the details. Make sure to select the Shift key as you continue to select these. If you over-selected, then use the Control key to deselect. Now that all the rows have been selected, the next step is to use the inset tool to give the section some edge to support the sub-D curvatures. Put this in slightly, but not too much. If this gets pulled too much, this will cause some undesirable details. Okay, so now that this has had the inset done, the next step is to extrude into the cylinder as shown. Doing this in small sections to support the inner loop. Just follow as shown to get a great outcome. Okay, now let's select the base of the cylinder, which is an N-gon face, which won't work well when converting this to a sub-D object. So let's select the face, and now let's inset this as well, and let's inset this a second time as shown on the video. Then let's delete the circle section face, and again we will proceed with the grid fill by hitting the Control F key to get the tools, and then select the grid fill. Go ahead and enter the same numbers so the outcome is similar. I use 12 for the span and 13 for the offset. Next, let's go back to the top section and we will proceed with the same process as below. Select the face and let's delete this, and now use the Alt key to select the edge loop and make sure you are in edge select mode or select 2 on the keyboard. Again, use the Control F key and select the grid fill, and this time we will use 16 in the span and adjust the offset to line it up correctly. Now that this has all been done, the next step is to go to the object mode and see how the lattices have modified the original cylinder. One thing that did not get taped in this section was I add in more resolution to the lattice cage for the taper, which is 4 on the U, 4 on the V and 5 on the W. This setting really helped drive the shape you see. If your shape is not correct, I suggest to go back to the taper lattice modifier and adjust again to get closer to this original shape. The next step is to now modify the other lattice to support the radius wrap turn. The shape is now starting to come along, and now just need the second lattice to give the shape the new curvature. Alright, almost done with the lattice effect. So now that I have the rotating lattice selected, I will start to rotate sections of this cage to create the effect. So let's now make sure you are set up on the X or Y axis so that this will be flat with the cage select. Now let's go to edit mode on the lattice, and now let's select the following. So basically, I selected all the points with the exception of the very bottom three base sections and rotated this at negative 15 degrees on the Z. So hit the R key and then select Z and then dial in the negative 15 degrees in the pullout. Now go from the top selection down, and this time leave the bottom four rows unselected, and again plan to rotate the sections another negative 15 degrees on the Z axis. Okay, let's continue the same process again on row 5 through 7, similar to the prior ones. Very cool, this is really starting to look smooth. Okay, so I selected the top 8 rows and went ahead and used S to scale down all point inward as shown on the video. Once this was done, now I am going back to the modifiers after I select the main cylinder object on the right side and going to now add in a subdivision modifier under the generate tab. Now I entered 3 on the levels viewport and 3 on the render section, but I should have just selected 2 for both inputs. 3 is way too high on the poly count, which made the file very large, and 2 came out great. Alright, this is how to create the nice smooth rotated form with the lattice tools. If you like these videos, please subscribe so that I can continue to create these. Thanks.